The new curriculum will be more practical than theoretical compared to the last one. This was revealed by Deputy Director of Research, Consultancy and Library Services at National Curriculum Development Center, Christopher Muganga. The previous curriculum had existed for so many years till 2020, when National Curriculum Development Center launched the new O-level curriculum that cut on the number of subjects students should opt for and adjustment on the time and its corresponding activities at school. He emphasized that the existing A-level curriculum is more theoretical, unlike the newly introduced O-level curriculum of 2020. He appealed to government to look into leveling the curriculum to the existing resources available in the community, and he urged employees to look beyond university credentials.
A-level revised curriculum is going to be needed very, very fast, because we are having the learners who are in senior two now, who are using constructivism as a method of learning, that is learning by skills, learning by doing, and by learning by reasoning why you are doing something for a purpose. So yet the A-level, which is current, it is again in cognitive, in the old system of narration, reading about and writing essays. So we have now to make a continuation of how these learners, when they come to senior four and graduate, how do they continue so that their learning is at least synchronized and we don't create that gap.
According to Christopher Muganga, Uganda is facing a challenge of unemployment, low skills, among other issues, but this can be addressed by adjusting the new A-level curriculum.
The first one is what is happening now in the societies or in the community, whereby people are crying unemployment, yet we have people who are educated. So we ask ourselves, what is it that they are not having for them to have employment? That's one factor. The second factor is the O-level, which we call senior to senior four, is already reviewed, and it is having a different direction it takes, whereby learners are learning by doing and practicing, which is called the competency-based, so that we are not looking for the knowledge, we are looking for what can you do with that knowledge. And the third factor is what are the employment and other pathways for these learners to go to. So why are employers not taking on A-level graduates? And after A-level, those who have not gone to other higher institutions, how do they survive? Those are the factors that are behind this research.
Myers Mumanyire, the head researcher, says while doing their research, they engaged and interviewed university chancellors, their vice, deans and heads of departments, because they receive the A-level products and make research on equilaterals abroad.
We have been consulting key stakeholders from universities and tertiary institutions. And these were mainly vice-chancellors, deputy vice-chancellors, academic registrars, and deans of faculties. Because, first of all, they are more exposed about different countries, how the equivalent of A-level of different countries, how they move.
He further affirmed the society should get rid of the existing curriculum because it's more theoretical with irrelevant content.
The science and the other histories and other subjects, things that have changed are still in the curriculum. So all those redundancies and repetitions and duplications will be removed because they have been identified.
It should be noted that government rolled out the new lower secondary education curriculum in February 2020 with the aim of meeting the learners' needs, especially in regard to skills training and enhancement. Report by Sharon Navasidie for the news.